today what I want to talk to you guys about is a inverter for your vehicle. And what I found here was the Victor 1200 watt, and it came with the leads here that you can hook up to you straight to your battery. Now, in all reality, what I wanted to do with mine, and let me turn this thing around because so you guys can see it. What an inverter is, it converts 12 volts to 120 volt AC. And I did pick this up used at the flea market. I've been looking for one and hadn't run across it. You know, I'm always out looking for a great deal. I think I picked this up for like 25 bucks. So I've had it in my truck. I've gotten wires, and what I was going to do is take these cable clamps off and wire it straight to my truck. My thinking of use with this right here was I go out to the hunt land a lot. I build deer stands and whatnot that I could take my battery chargers, hook it to the, my inverter here, my power source, and charge my batteries up while I'm working on my deer stands or whatever. But so happens that I bought a home about 7 years ago, and the numbnuts, they took and run the water line. I'm on city water. I'm right outside of the city limits, but I am on city water, and they run. There's a long dirt road, probably 300-400 yards. They run the water line right down the dirt road. Total idiots. And they run it with that. Some of you older guys can remember the black half-inch, three-quarter black polytubing line that it breaks. You know, used to have them in Wales. And that's what they run it. I call it roll piping is what it is. What I call it. But anyway, they run it about 18 inches under the ground, and every time the motor grader comes down my dirt road, it busts. So I have to go out there and fix it. So when I dig up the spot where it was leaking at, cut my water off at the meter, go up the back to the thing, dig up the pipe, enough room for me to work on it. Well, even though you got your water off, and you try to drain it out here at your house, there's no pressure pushing through. So you got about 300-400 yards worth of water in that pipe. Well, it just, once you cut that pipe, it fills that hole back up. And normally I'd get me a pail or whatever and I'd dip it out. Well, you have to dip it out, and then when you cut it, it fills back up anyway. It just overflows, and you have to dip it out, and you dip it out 18 inches of water and a couple foot long. So you just get aggravated doing it. I said, man, there's got to be a better way. I said, only if I had some power, and I remember that I bought this. So I run back to the shop and got my shop vac. Took this out in front of the truck. Opened the hood, plugged it up. Straight up. It pumped it right out, just like it should have. It pumped it out, saved me 30-40 minutes of dipping it out. Got the pipe fixed, got it all sealed back up. And covered back up. So this one I'm going to leave with the clamps itself. I will buy me probably a new one to mount in my truck. These are really good to be put in campers, motorhomes, and stuff like that. It's good for survival. You always got some way, as long as you got 12-volt battery charged up, you got some way to make it to 110 power. And in this case, the shop vac pulled more than what this would pull, so I really had to just crank the truck up, cut this on, and it fired it right up. You know, guys, stay tuned for more videos. We got more to come. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on our YouTube channel. Follow us on MaximumSurvivors.com. Thank you for watching. Always remember to be careful, and God bless America.